Welcome back to take a look at the biggest movers in the market. Right now, looking at Weight Watchers, well, that's soaring to the upside. Up, is that right? 40% after posting a higher full-year earnings forecast. Match Group also up double digits on better than expected second quarter revenue. And here's a look at CVS Health gaining on the day after beating earnings expectations and raising full-year earnings per share guidance. And then there's Disney. That is down on the day after missing both the top and bottom line earnings estimates. We're going to break down those numbers later in the show. Let's take a quick look at the Bitcoin right now. Bitcoin futures, the cryptocurrency. Well, that's been hovering around this 12,000 mark. You can see, in fact, it is down slightly on the day. For now, let's get right to some short calls on the market. Melissa Armo is here, founder and owner of the Stock Swoosh, on a day where the market certainly seems nervous. It's nice to see you, Melissa. Thanks for coming in. The market seems nervous. I was watching this morning as bond yields were dropping. Market's going down along with it. Some people would say, wow, great buying opportunity, but not you. Don't buy the dip, you're saying.
No, I mean, yesterday, look at what happened yesterday. First of all, on Monday's collapse, when you look at the way that we closed Friday, we were down, okay? Go back to Friday, we were down. We held the 50-period moving average and all the market indices, the QQQs, the diamonds, and the SPY. And then Monday morning, we were down huge. Gap down so big. Monday was the biggest sell-off day I think we might have had this year. I'd really have to look at it. But
correct.
We absolutely collapsed. We absolutely cratered on Monday. And then we cratered at night. So Monday night, and this is what's really interesting, and I noticed it. And again, I look at gaps, but I'm looking at the pre-market activity and the post-market activity. And, you know, the one night, remember when they came out with the Mexican tariffs? This is like weeks and weeks ago. The market collapsed at night. This was like that on Monday, but it was really just huge selling. That wasn't a tweet, wasn't anything. It was just massive selling on Monday night. Now, we did rally yesterday, but it was a pathetic rally as far as I'm concerned. So I wasn't surprised then when we gapped down this morning. And today is a great example of a very choppy day. We gapped down, then we dropped, then we rallied. I mean, who knows how we closed today?
Do you think that the, and that's true. I mean, that's what we saw is this selling upon selling. And to your point, on Monday, we dropped 767 points. And overnight, it was probably another 600 or so. We came up from that. So it was a big move to the upside off those lows. You think the Fed cuts unexpectedly with a surprise cut between now and September?
I don't know if that's going to happen because really, when you look at it, I mean, we're a couple weeks away from September, but there's really no specific hard data coming out or any big earnings that could really move this market higher. In my opinion, why would anyone buy here in a new level, even though we're still at this prior support in the 200-day moving average? I can't see why anyone would get into any new positions here.
So if you want to short this market, right, you're talking about the spiders, the triple Q, the DIA, right? You called it the diamonds. You get in there and you short it. What are you shorting? What are you expecting? How much drop?
Well, I called the market short, to be honest with you, last Thursday. Then I called it again Friday. And then I said we'd crater Friday, and then we did. So really, I mean, people that are my clients have been short for the last week. So they're already up. And as far as the shorts go, you kind of get out with profit, or I say, listen, you can hold, because I really seriously think that the Dow could go down to 25,000. And if we break that, I don't think that would look good.
Right.
And so the levels I have is about 175 for the QQQs, 272, 270 for the SPY. This is to the downside, okay?
Right.
And the diamonds, again, that 250 number, because honestly, again, we're getting into a period, this whole year has been like an angel. We rallied.
Okay, I think we need to slow down.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so for the S&P,
yes.
Your level was what?
Well, 272 in the SPY, so that would be 2,720
right.
If you're looking at the S&P.
2,720 if
yes.
You're looking at the cash.
Right. Or you could just say 2,700, really.
Right.
You know, these are areas.
Right.
Yes.
So that would really
That would be
you.
Bad.
Right.
That would be not good.
And then do you have a level on the Dow or no?
Well, that's what I'm saying, 25,000.
Right. Okay. And then
we're not that far away
from
there.
Right. And the triple Qs right now?
175.
Right. So you also say certain names, right? I mean, Netflix has been a name that has come under some scrutiny, and that's one of the names that you really think can move lower.
Netflix really is lower. I mean, I'm just, Netflix has, it's such a big target, and I'm just gonna put it out there, because I thought we hit through 300 a day. We hit through 300 a day in the first 5 minutes of trading. Wow. We gapped down and boom, we went like that. We fell off the planet in the first 5 minutes today, Netflix, 280, 270 Netflix. I mean, these are not even crazy numbers, and this is without the market. I'm talking about Netflix can just fall by itself alone. That stock has been trending down. And remember, I'm looking at momentum. So the momentum right now is to the downside. And that's what I'm saying. Like yesterday, people were like, buy the dip, buy the gap up. We had no follow through. No follow through today from the rally. No big buyers coming in. No follow through is not good if you want to go long. So if the follow through is to the downside, why not play it? Again, if you're an active trader. Now, it depends what your time horizon is. If you're a long-term investor, I'm not saying the market breaks the uptrend. We're in the uptrend. Even if we get down to 25,000 in the Dow, we're still holding the uptrend in the market.
Right.
But I'm saying if you're an active trader, which many of AmeriTrade's traders, many of your viewers are active traders, I'd be doing puts, I'd be doing shorts, I'd be looking for weakness. And I mean, to go long right now, I would have to have like 100% conviction and look at something that's perfect.
You also had Boeing on that list.
I've been liking that Boeing since the last time we talked. Yeah.
Right. So this would be a short, right?
Short.
Why? You know, great American company. It has defense contracts. They've been very honest about the 737 MAX, but you think that
didn't perform well in the earnings? Fell after the earnings just recently, and no buyers coming in.
Right.
No buyers coming in. All the things you're saying are correct. You could say the same thing about the market. Look how strong the economy is. We just lowered rates. And in fact, last week, and this is what was a telltale sign before this collapse, before this crater this week, the Fed lowered rates and the market went boom, and it went like that day. I'm sure you covered it. It fell the day we said, well, wait a minute. Why did the market fall when they just lowered rates? Everyone should be happy and no.
Well, because they wanted more. The market's very greedy these days. The market wants at least 2-3 rate cuts, right? I mean, that's really what the market is looking for. What about money moving out of China and the global economy slowing in the world? I mean, in fact, Europe was closing a little higher today. So it shows that the whole world wasn't completely spooked. But we did have several countries cut rates overnight. What are you thinking?
Well, I mean, again, what's happening with the tariff war right now, which definitely, I mean, people were saying before they didn't want to call it a trade war.
Yeah.
It's a trade war. This is going on. This is going on far longer than people anticipated.
Do you think it goes on through the election?
I think this goes on, and I'm putting this out there, too. I think that this is going to go through into another 5 years. Like, I don't even think this gets resolved. Not only this year, not only next year. I'm saying there's a possibility this might be, if Trump gets reelected, the very last thing he does in his second term, like I'm talking 2024. And to be honest with you, it may never get resolved, because right now the U.S. government is making money on the tariffs that are coming in. So that's happening. And corporations got the tax benefits, but they're the ones right now currently that are paying tariffs for the goods. And, you know, eventually I believe that it could be passed on to the consumer if this goes on for another 5 years plus.
First of all, I mean, we should mark this day because you're the first person to say it's going to go quite so long and you never know.
Talk about
the institutional money. I think that was one of the things that you noted, a lack of institutional money to support the move, right?
Yes, exactly. And again, that has to do with the lack of the follow through, because the rally we had yesterday, again, you know, if you're gonna look at a chart and you're gonna get in and you're an active trader, you want to make money right away.
So that's basically the smart money is not putting
smart
money
isn't stepping
in on the side.
Their smart money isn't stepping in. In fact, the smart money is selling, because when you have a day like Monday, that's massive selling. You don't have a down day like that without big money selling. Now remember, people are up. The market's made new highs. Remember, we talked back in May, and I was early because I was anticipating this, but it didn't happen. And then we kind of creepy crawled up, but we never had a jolt up. We just made little ups. But you know what? I was bearish the last time we talked, it was July 5th. July 5th, it was around that July 4th holiday. I was talking about it with you the last time I was on, and I said, I think the market's lower. And that was unusual for me because I've been so bullish for so long. And now I'm like, wait a minute, I don't think we're going to hold here. And then we kind of rally, but it was like a baby rally.
All right, so what I'm interested in is when you're going to change your tune back to something a little bullish.
I'll let you know the second it happens.
Right now, that's not it.
I don't see that happening anytime
soon. And I know Disney is your baby. We're talking a lot about it later in the show, but I'll give you 10 seconds.
Well, I would not short Disney today. even though it gapped down.
But you loved
it. I wouldn't go long it either. I still love it long term. I'm talking 2020, 2021. I'm talking 1 to 2 years out. Long time calls.
All right.
Long term calls if you want to buy Disney. Or even, again, I don't buy gap downs, but you could go long Disney on a dip because the fact is that the stock is strong. And this move down today wasn't a crater. It wasn't like the market.
Right.
It was a small move down.
All right.
I still like the stock long. But when you look at that at Netflix, it's like, it's very interesting the way these two companies are shifting and everything's happening.
I think it's interesting how you have your short on Netflix.
And Disney bought Fox. So when that was the reason they gave the explanation.
All right.
For that.
Melissa Armo, founder and owner of the Stock Swoosh.
Thanks for having
me. Great to see you. Changing her tune lately a little bit, right? A little more cautious. Indeed. Great to see you. Well, coming up next, we're going to be taking a look at some of the global bond rally and how the prices of those bonds, the impact on the U.S. market. We'll be right back. The market is selling off right now. The Dow Jones Industrial Average down 205 points after.